I'm Jennifer, and welcome to my library. Today on Book Talk, we are going to be talking, I'm going to be talking about a book I just finished reading last night, Pegasus and the Flame of Olympus. When Pegasus crashes onto the roof of Emily's Manhattan apartment, her life changes forever. Emily is thrust into the center of a force building between the Roman gods and a terrifying race of multi-armed stone warriors called Nadras, excuse me. She must join forces with a thief named Pallion, the goddess Diana, and a boy named Joel to return Pegasus to Olympus and rescue the gods from certain death. Along the way, they will fight monsters run from a government agency that is prepared to dissect Pegasus and even fly above the Manhattan skyline. It is all part of the quest to save Olympus before the Olympic flame burns out. Now, when I originally saw the book cover, I was like, oh, this is amazing because I love Pegasi. They're one of my favorite mythical creatures. Dragons, obviously, if you've seen any of my movie talk videos, you know I absolutely love dragons. Well, not any of them, but a few of them. Unicorns, I love unicorns as well. And chimeras, and not the chimeras from like Greek mythology, but if you actually look up the term chimera in the dictionary, I believe it'll actually say that a chimera is actually a combination of two or more different species. So like a cat or a dog combined together would be a chimera, and I'm just using that as an example. So I do like chimeras as well. I actually do some free writing on my own. I haven't been published, unless you count having one of your stories published in the school newspaper as being published. And I actually do quite a few on chimeras. But I try to make them look a little more cuddlier than they are in like the mist, but I'm digressing. So I love Pegasi. So that's kind of what originally drew me, was the beautiful white Pegasus on the cover. And then again, I read the back and I thought, oh wow, this sounds very interesting. And so I started reading it and I just finished it last night. I have quite a few books in this series. I believe I'm 5 books in the series. I just got a good view of my Pegasus books. I have like 5 books in the series. I don't know how many there are. I believe there are 6, maybe 7. Just got like a bunch for Christmas this year. And so I started reading this, and when I actually got a couple chapters into it, I'm like, wow, this is a really good book. I really like it. I want to, you know, find out more of what happens with Emily and Pegasus. And so I got the second and third book, I believe, myself. And then when Christmas rolled around, my mom, I always, you know, text or write out a list of what I want for my mom. And a lot of them are like DVDs and books. And I had written down the Pegasus books I hadn't had. Didn't have yet, and I got 4 and 5. I do have up to book 5. Haven't obviously read them yet, as I just finished the first one last night. But the first one was really good, so I'm assuming I'm going to go out on a limb and say that the other 4 books are also going to be very good. Really, really enjoyed this book. I mean, I probably would have finished it earlier if I had actually read a chapter a night every night since I started reading it, which I really didn't do, because sometimes I went to bed and I didn't read at all. Sometimes I only read a couple, like, chapter from 3 books, and sometimes I read a chapter from all the books that I like to read before bed. So, I'm going to try and be a little better on that. It was actually really good. There were mentions of some gods that I didn't know about, like the thief. I didn't know there was a thief god. Obviously, I should have known that, as there seemed to be a god for everyone in the Greek and Roman world. Well, I didn't know what they represented in the different, like the human gods in within this book, like Diana and Jupiter and Apollo and Vesta. I didn't know what they were the god or goddess of within the movie. Within the book, I was like, I know more about the Greek gods than I do the Roman gods. It's just the so a lot of times when I was reading the book, I was replacing Diana's name in my head with Athena, who she is in the Greek stories and myths. Same thing with Jupiter. I was replacing his name in my head with Zeus. Only because I do know a little bit more about those particular gods than I do about the Roman ones. Saving grace is that the Roman gods and the Greek gods, the only real difference between them were their names. The Romans, when they conquered Greece, actually adapted the Greek beliefs, religious beliefs, gods and goddesses into their culture, and they just really changed the names of the gods and goddesses to the different ones. And if you know anything about Roman mythology, you know that quite a few of the gods are actually named after planets. We have Mercury, who is Hermes, the messenger god. Venus, who is Aphrodite, the goddess of love. Mars, who is also Aries, the god of war. Jupiter, who is also Zeus, the king of the gods. Saturn, and I don't know his equivalent in Greek mythology, but he is, I believe, the god of the harvest. It is a he. You think, oh my god, you think the god of the harvest would be a female, but it's not. It's a guy. Neptune, also known as Poseidon, who is the god of the sea. He's actually Jupiter slash Zeus's brother, one of his brothers. Uranus, I don't know his, again, I don't know his Greek name, and I don't know what he's the god of. And then Pluto, and I do still consider Pluto a planet, because when I was in school, he was a planet. I may be dating myself here a little bit, but Pluto was a planet when I was in school, so I still consider Pluto a planet. And in Greek mythology, Hades, who was the god of the underworld, and he was the third of the brothers. So yeah, a lot of our planets, with the exception of the planet we live on, of course, were actually named after Roman gods and goddesses. Some of them I know why, some of them I don't. Jupiter, obviously, because it's the biggest, so it was named after the king of the gods. Mercury, because it has the shortest rotation around the sun, and Mercury slash Hermes was very fast. Venus, known as our sister planet, I guess that's just why it was named Venus. Mars, because it's red, and blood's red, and you see a lot of blood in war. The others, I'm not 100% sure on why. But I'm digressing. This is not about Greek mythology. Really cute movie. I had trouble picturing the Natters in my head. Just not because they were poorly described in the book. They were actually described very well. Just, I had a really hard time picturing something in my head. Picturing them in my head. So what I actually ended up doing was, anybody who has seen Attack of the Clones, you know, Drex, Obi-Wan's friend who runs the diner, I actually pictured the Natters kind of like him a little bit. Not because I didn't like him. I actually did like Drex. I thought he was very, a very unique character. Just because he was just big and kind of a little intimidating, and he did have four arms. So I'm like, okay, I'm just going to picture these Natters like him a little bit, only without the chef outfit on. With a different form of dress on. Just mostly because I just didn't have anything else to pick to really set my mind on there, and I'm just like, I'll just go with Drex. I'll just go with Drex and the one Jedi from the Four Arc were who's left in charge of the 501 precinct when Anakin's called back to Coruscant. And I'll just picture him like that. I was like, either that or General Grievous. And General Grievous just didn't strike me as someone to picture the Natters after, because he's mostly a droid, and the Natters weren't droids. And if you can't tell, I really love Star Wars. I did the so and Diana, oh my God, Diana slash Athena, one of my favorite goddesses from Greek and Roman mythology. I mean, she really is one of my favorites. I do probably because she is the goddess of wisdom. No, Minerva was Athena. Excuse me. Athena. Diana was Artemis. Again, another one of my favorite guys. I'm sorry, I got a little confused there. Minerva was Athena, and Diana is Artemis. Excuse me. I had that confused. I do tend to mix up the gods a little bit, particularly when I'm trying to pair the Roman and Greek names together. So I apologize for getting that confused. But Artemis is also another one of my favorite Greek goddesses, and I think the main reason why I like her is that she is the goddess of the hunt. And not because I'm a hunter, but because if you read a lot of the myths, despite the fact that she is a huntress, she respects the wild animals. And I love animals. So she's kind of like not only the goddess of the moon and the goddess of the hunt, but also the goddess of wild animals. So I think that's part of the reason why I like her so much. And again, I just really love her. She is one of my top four or five favorite Greek gods and goddesses. I like her. I like Athena. I do like Aphrodite. I didn't so much like Aphrodite in Hercules and Xena. I felt she came off a little ditzy. But that was just kind of the way she was written. just like kind of in the movie Hera, in Hercules and Xena, Hera kind of came off as a little bit of a witch, and I'm using a nice word here. I have another word which you can probably figure out what I meant. But in the myth, she's really not that way. Same thing with Aphrodite. I mean, she came off really ditzy and bubble-headed and clueless in Hercules the Legendary Adventures and in Xena Warrior Princess, but in the myths she's really not. It's just the way the script was written. Particularly with Hercules, they kind of had to make Hera the quintessential bad guy because Hercules was the son of Zeus, he wasn't the son of Hera, except for in the Disney movie, which was poetic licensing, but we'll get more into that in TV talk and movie talk. So I like them. I also like Poseidon. And I like four. I thought so. Okay, so four I like. But anyways. So this is really interesting. And like I said, they did do the Roman. I guess because you don't see a lot in the. I guess the reason Katie O'Hare, who's the author of this book, did the Roman gods, I guess it's because you see a lot on the Greek gods, you don't see quite as much on the Roman gods. So I guess that's just why she decided to go with the Roman gods. I do not know if in Roman mythology if they live on Olympus or not. I don't do that much reading on the Roman gods, just because I can't really find that much. I do know that the Greek gods live on Olympus. It's mentioned basically anything where you see that's connected to Hercules and whatnot, they are on Olympus. Anyways, so I'm digressing. Really cute, really wonderful movie, or book, excuse me. I just did a movie talk video. Really great book. I loved the book a lot. I love the bond between Emily and Pegasus. It's like, it's really, as you're reading the book and they're talking about what they have to do to save Olympus, you really get the point very early on once they mention what they have to do to save Olympus that Emily has a role to play in that just because of her bond with Pegasus and what they do to protect Pegasus, particularly because Diana being human. Can actually, and Paladin being human, I don't know if that's actually how you say his name, but that's what I'm going to call him. Being human-ish, looking more human than, like, say, Pegasus and theirs, they can just change their clothes and, from the Greek robes to, you know, what we wear. And they can blend in. Pegasus really couldn't because of his wings. So what they do to hide him, Emily and Joel, is really ingenious, and I don't want to really give it away too much, but he does look ex different, and he does go back to looking the way he did at the end of the mo at the end of the book. And so it's just really ingenious, and you see people, the government agency, I think it was called the CUR, but I could be wrong. They mentioned it a couple times what its actual name was, and they used a lot of the abbreviations, and the people there are not nice. I'm going to tell you that right now. They are, aside from the Natters, the quintessential bad guys of the book. And again, I don't even know if like the bad if the foreign creatures are actually called Natters. That's just what I'm calling them. I shouldn't say Natters. Because that's more what Stormfly was in How to Train Your Dragon. But I really that's I can't I don't know I don't have an audio of this, so I'm not hearing what the author actually called them, so I'm just calling them what I think they are. And anyway, so I'm getting off track here. I don't know if the Natters are going to be back in the next book or not, because they were essentially defeated at the end of this book. I mean, obviously you know that they're going to be defeated to some degree. But it's really interesting. It's a really good book. Really gripping. It like really like you want when you finish a page, you want to turn the page to find out what happens. So it's like that good. And I really need to wrap up this video. Say so I really recommend checking out Pegasus and the Flame of Olympus and the other Pegasus books. I plan to start reading the second book in the series, which is called Pegasus and Olympus at War. I plan to start reading that tonight. I will hopefully have a video ready to be posted. This was actually a 33 chapter book, so the other book is 33 chapters as well, or somewhere along those lines. I'll have another video posted in on Pegasus. I'll have the video on Pegasus and the War of Olympus posted sometime in May, so look forward to that. And I believe my next video, which will hopefully be within a few weeks, will be on Star Wars Kenobi, because I'm only if I believe I'm less than two, less than a little over 2/3 of the way finished with that. I believe I'm well into the last third of the chapter. I just finished reading chapter 33 last night. Do not know how many chapters are in there, but I know I'm on the third part of the book and. Well into the third part of the book, and it's only a three-part book, so really nearing the end. I can actually see the book from here. I'm really close to the end. I've got about maybe this much of the book to read, and the book's about this thick. So yeah, I should probably be able to finish that in a while, and we will talk about that later. Be prepared for a lot of talk on that book because Obi-Wan is because not only is Obi-Wan one of my favorite Star Wars characters, Star Wars is one of my favorite franchises, so I will probably jabberjaw a lot on that one and any of this, anything that has to do with Star Wars, the TV shows, the movies, the other books. So I'm going to apologize up front right now, and I'll probably do that at the beginning of the Kenobi book talk video, and any of the other Star Wars videos. I will apologize up front that you will probably get a earful. Like a lot of me babbling about things on that just because I love Star Wars so much. So I'm going to sign off. I'm Jennifer. Thank you for visiting my library, and I will see you next time.